Are we really going to take the word of peasants and travelers?
Only the finest goods here. See for yourself.
Couldn't find better ways.
Get all the best goods here.
It's always the ones you least expect that cause you trouble.
I've sent a messenger to the claim to let everyone know.
If there's anything you or your clan need for her arrangements, you need but ask.
They'll be...
I'm glad you're back. I'm at a loss about Ursa. To learn she lives, then lose that hope seems cruel.
She wouldn't want us to waste time talking. She'd want us to find Durval. She said he raved about smoke darkening the sun. Tell him what you found in his papers.
A letter. It mentioned a shipment of Blaze being sent to a warehouse here. Only, it wasn't addressed to Duval. The name was Aland Forgeman. Does that mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar. Yes, a landlord. The Osiram have been buying up buildings across the city, including one under that name. Let me think. It's by the edge of the mesa, near the temple. Used to be a shop, but it could serve as a warehouse. If Durval used the name as an alias to buy it, he might even be there now.
I'll round up my men.
I'll meet you there.
Erend, wait. Remember that no one hates Durval more than your own tribe. The clans would give up much to obtain him.
Take him alive? So you can haggle over him? You can't be serious!
Our security depends on keeping the peace. If the opportunity presents itself, take him alive. Consider that a command. Aloy, a moment, please. When we spoke, Erend didn't wish to dwell on the details of Ursa's death. Understandable, of course. But now that they've been left to my imagination, those details are all I can think about. You were there. Did she suffer?
She wasn't worried about her pain. She was worried about her brother. And she was worried about you.
Thank you, Aloy. I suppose I needed to know I was as much on her mind as she is on mine. Find Durval and bring him before me. He will answer for his crimes.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy.
This is the place. You home, Durval? I got a surprise for you. Is it a bomb? Doesn't look too big.
Big enough to kill us.
All right. I'll shut up.
Blaze. It must be leaking from something upstairs. If that bomb goes off, the blaze will ignite in a
firestorm. That's a lot of blaze.
If that bomb downstairs goes off, it'll be just what Durval promised. Smoke will darken the sun as the city goes up in flames. There's gotta be a way to stop it. If I try to take it apart, a booby trap will set it off. Like a wooden bracket. Not very strong. Help me push this out.
Okay. Brute force. I'm good at that. What'll it do?
Save the city, I hope. But when the blaze falls, run for it. Because the booby trap on the bomb downstairs is gonna get set off.
Will we survive?
Probably not. Now push.
We did it! Durval's best shot, and Meridian's still standing.
This isn't over. Durval said he'd make a VOD watch.
No way. To do that, he'd have to get into the palace. Now that's too heavily guarded.
Get back there, just to be sure. I'm gonna look around. Maybe Durval's men left something behind when they planted that bomb.
I got it. Don't worry. He tries for the palace. He's finished.
Good tracks. It's just a bit of blaze in them.
An explosion! This one will open the ceasefire.
Can I interest you in a reasonable share of a lucrative opportunity?
All the best goods. It'll cost you a shard just to look.
What happened?
I haven't heard a blast like that since the liberation.
Let's have a chat. No, a colorful discussion.
There's smoke rising from the edge of the mesa.
Are we under attack? The tracks lead inside. Another one of Durval's hideouts. This must be where Durval assembled the detonator. He tunneled through the wall. Durval did find a way into the palace.
I wish I could be there to see this.
Then we do it the hard way.
Ah! Heads down, boys!
Ah! need them soon enough.
Of a maniac king. You robbed me of my right to kill your father, so I'll have to settle for you. I'm going to enjoy watching the Karja burn, even more because you'll be watching with me. Say goodbye to Meridian, Avad. Breathe in the stench and choke on the ashes. Something's wrong. I didn't hear anything.
There's a bit of smoke rising from the mesa's edge.
No! It should be a firestorm, not some belch from a charcoal burner! You must be the Nora who bushwhacked my camp.
And disabled your bomb.
Did you now? Well, bomb or no bomb, I'm gonna splatter that throne with blood. First yours, then Avad's.
Contact!
Why does Avad always have his ladies do the fighting? I've led an army, killed kestrels and ravagers. Nothing. Can we finish this? I've got a sun god to kill. Yet, Nora. Any good Osaram tinker will tell you. Always have a third plan.
Who, me?
Things, because there's more in the way. Never do the work if you can get a machine to do it for you. Majestic, murderous glint hawks.
Thank you.
As much as I wish Ursa was here to kill you, I don't mind doing it for her.
Go ahead. I'm not afraid. Except that knowing you, Aaron, you'll screw it up!
I know what you are afraid of. Going back to Mainspring in chains. Every clan in the claim wants you dead. And they know how to make it hurt. They'll even bid for the privilege.
It's just like you to get someone else to do your killing.
Shut up. You're at the Sun King's mercy now.
Aloy, to say you have my gratitude feels woefully insufficient. You saved my life. You saved Meridian. And because of you, there will be justice for Ursa's murder. We can mourn her knowing the truth without painful uncertainty. It's hard.
What exactly will happen to Derval?
For now, he'll languish in one of the old cells under the Sun Ring here in Meridian. As for what happens after we negotiate his extradition to Mainspring, I don't want to think about it. My father was very creative when it came to inflicting suffering. But some Oseram devices surpass even his imaginings. What a waste. Derval is a brilliant man. I wonder what he would have accomplished if it weren't for my father's cruelty.
Why do you want me to stay in Merid?
I would think that would be obvious.
Not to me.
Huh. Well, to start with, you kept the city from going up in flames. You're strong, shrewd, and capable. I could use someone like you at my side.
Thank you for the offer, but I don't think either you or I are ready for that. I've got a long way to go before I find what I'm looking for, and it's gonna take me far from Meridian.
Of course. I didn't mean to presume. You are your own woman. But please, remember that you're always welcome here. I hope that today is just a sunrise for us, not a goodbye.
It's time for me to go.
Of course. I hope you find what you're after, Aloy. And if need be, I will come to your aid. As sure as...
Aloy. I was just thinking about Ursa. She would have killed Derval on the spot. I know it. That's why she went out to meet him in the first place, to put him down. But she also told me to grow up. I gotta admit, it burned a little when she said that, but I'm trying to take it to heart. And I guess growing up means putting what you should do in front of what you want to do. Right?
You're asking me? I'm pretty sure you're older.
Yeah, but I don't act like it, do I?
You did with Derval.
Don't give me too much credit. Part of me still wants to wait for a quiet moment and wring his neck.
Yeah, but you won't. Because you're a good captain.
Come on, stop. You're gonna make me tear up.
Well...
I know. You gotta go. Killers to track, machines to master. All before breakfast. You know what? When we met, I thought I was a big shot talking to a pretty girl hidden away in the middle of nowhere. And now I see that I was just lucky to get a minute of your time. Try not to forget about me while you're out there changing the world.
I'll always have a minute for you. Maybe even two.
Two? Huh. She likes me.
Everything's in order.
You'll regret not stopping when you're in the thick of it.
Look.
Take a look at these wares.
Thank you.
right?
You're an out?
No.
Then you may... They can... It... Yes, yes. I will leave. What do my tires... I see. A hunter, surely. Come, talk to me a moment.
Stocking up. Save these for the trail. That'll help. Might need that.
You miserable chump.
I see where they've caged up the captives. Haven't you got anything better to do? All right. I'd have to leave something else behind.
The machines have been driven wild. Our family and friends lie dead. What hope is there left for us?
To get off my feet. Thank you.
This must be the pass that Tom was talking about. It's the new time to just come.
Thank you. You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
You made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
Smoke rising from the mountain. And the village, too. What's it for? Must be something big going on. Most of the village is moving towards that smoke.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora.
Bergrind, purveyor of necessities. Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead, but not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye, a nasty business. All their best warriors lost. So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. Falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us. And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Blood is in your teeth, Aratak!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
The daemon that frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best. And what do they want to do? Go back up there. Fools. A little advice. For free.
Aloy.
Aloy. I've been up here for two long winters, and I still can't make sense of the Banuk. Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Aurea, spouting on about spirits and daemons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Warwick up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines. When Aurea vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her. But no. Here's Big Aratak, gearing them up to do it all over again.
I want to know more about this daemon.
Mm-mm. It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then you need to find Aurea. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks. But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow. Strange new structures. Some say a new machine, like no one seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Bergrund.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if Aratok can tell me more about Aurea and Thunderstrong. Might be worth a shot.
Where once Banuk were dragged to Meridian in chains, now Banuk can live there as equals.
It's unnatural, seeing the tall neck leaning against the ice like that.
Whatever happened.